Duty Operations Manager Jordan is en route to the Sydney Harbour Bridge.
All I know right now is that a woman is trapped on the Harbour Bridge and has collapsed.
Two additional units have also been dispatched, as well as police rescue.
This could be at its worst, a cardiac arrest. Maybe she's dehydrated and she's fainted. There's just so many possibilities.
Do you want to have her sitting in here, or do you want to
stop them on the road?
Yeah.
This job is all about teamwork. Effecting this rescue, keeping everyone safe, will only be achieved if we work together.
Hey, how are you?
Ambulance is not the rescue agency. We need to work with police rescue to extricate this patient off the bridge.
How you going?
It's 35 degrees up there, and when you're up on a big piece of steel, that heat poses a real threat to the patient.
Wow, heat is brutal.
After 22 minutes, the patient has been successfully extricated from the bridge and is currently conscious and responsive.
We haven't tried setting her up.
But she must now be taken out of the heat and to hospital for a full assessment.
If this is heat stroke, one of the first things you do is remove people from the source of that heat.
You're going to need to be taken up to hospital and monitored for a few hours.
People often underappreciate how dangerous heat-related illness can be.
Yeah.
It can cause unconsciousness and coma. It can cause organ failure of multiple organ systems. But this patient should be okay.
Pull over if you need anything.
When you get to a scene and it's not as bad as first thought, that can be quite a relief.
Thanks, guys. Have a great day.
There are plenty of unlucky cases where the patients don't do as well as this lady has. In the back of my mind, I'm conscious that if the cards had fallen differently, she may in fact have passed away. The tragic reality is that it's easy for bad things to happen, but if that does happen, you should call us.